Vivi versus Haze, starting off on Final Destination.
Battle of the Furries.
What are your thoughts on Final Destination for this matchup?
I don't like it for Lucario, but Vivi loves FD, so we'll see what happens.
I feel like Lucario is just like able to just like, with an FD of such limited approach options, no platforms to dance around, Lucario is definitely a character where like, you have to make a million calculations in your head at once to be like, damn, how am I going to go in on him? But Vivi getting the forward air dropping neutral out, a clean 31%.
As for Wolf, I feel like it should be a pretty comfortable matchup for him. Like, you can always, if Lucario has aura, you can always like play the laser cam game.
Yep.
And if you have to get the stock early, you can spam back airs. Wolf, just good neutral, good advantage. If Haze can shut Vivi down, he can take this.
Yep. But right now, like, Haze is doing a great job of just, like, keeping Vivi out. And it seems like right now in this set so far, Vivi is being the aggressive. Almost getting the second or his favorite.
I was going to say, great early recovery coming out from him because he didn't have his jump and he didn't want to get pressured. But Vivi being
ready with the F-Smash.
Yeah, two steps ahead. Read the panic option and just F-Smashed him.
Right now, Vivi getting so many strings off of forward air. I can't help but suspect that maybe Haze's DI is a little bit on like suboptimal, especially on forward air up. Just a mix-up, DI mix-up.
I don't even want to say that, because I've been hit with those strings before, and I've DI'd it every way.
Yeah.
You just get hit. He just finds the next hit every time. Oh, he didn't down smash.
He's maybe trying to get the jab block, I think, with the soft hit of the falling neutral, which definitely would have spelled the end of Vivi's stock.
I don't think he could have gotten it at that percent, though. Vivi a bit too high. Oh, going for the side special. Kind of a big hitbox, especially at the aura that Vivi's packing right now.
Wow, and the neutral beating out the aura sphere.
I don't care about your aura.
Ooh, and he dropped all of his stage control.
Whoa, wait! That was the thing! He did the thing!
He did the charging neutral beat into an up air?
That's so dumb! Dude, why can he do that? And the up air hits behind him. Oh, he's in the nair.
The nair more than enough to take out the
stun. Maybe you're not chic about this. If you've already worked a lot this game, you're kind of chilling.
And Haze has to be more careful with his landing options. You just saw him whiff that forward air, not even hitting the shield, not getting the shield stun on it, and Vivi just grabbing him for free.
Oh, dash attack. I thought he was going to do something with that stage control. Oh, what? Dash attacks are just hitting. You know, they have, like, the same dash attack, actually.
Yeah, you're right.
They just put there for forward.
He's the one that's going to get grabbed, but I thought the grab came out from Vivi.
Yeah, I don't know. They're kind of scrapping right now. Haze finally working with some stage control.
Ooh,
see what he can do with
jump it. Lead, but Vivi more than enough drift to circumvent it and get around him.
Yeah, not only that, but Vivi's kind of go-to option at ledge is, you know, jump fair. But that's just because fair is just such a good option from ledge. It comes out really quick and it pops. Oh, F-smash.
Wow.
That's going to pop him off stage.
Brutal.
And that'll be game one. Kind of quick, you know, not hardly 3 minutes. The aura is with him.
Yep.
Green Cario out here. I like the scarf, by the way.
I love the scarf. I think it's a fantastic choice.
Kalos.
Oh, question for Jewel, mainly Vivi's gameplay, but also in your Robin that you guys never show the shield when canceling B charge. Is there any way to consistently do it than other than tapping the shield button? Well, when you're landing, I know for a fact that whenever you have a charging neutral B, you can try to input jump just before you land, and that will also allow you to cancel your charging neutral B.
Yeah, I do that on accident more often than not, sadly. But if you mean, like, if you're just charging on the ground, I mean, you can just hit the X button. Like, you don't have to shield and then jump.
Yep.
Right? I mean, in Smash 4, you had to shield and then, you know, operate out of that.
But regardless, so sorry to interrupt
you. Just want to get a little bit back into the set.
Right now, Vivi keeping Haze offstage, a fantastic forward throw. Just, like, get off me. I'm going to perpetuate your disadvantage just a little bit longer.
Yeah. So Haze, not too concerned about the stage layout. You know, we're just going to FD2.
Yep.
He probably wanted more options off of the ledge.
Yep. But I feel like...
Well, forget ledge. You got to grab it first. Vivi just following him.
Mm-hmm. But I do think FD and Kalos are really great stages for Wolf as well. He's able to get great tech chases, but Vivi just keeping
Vivi, when he's feeling himself, it should be banned.
Oh, that was really, really dangerous
because he didn't get the throw. And that's it.
Wow.
I don't think he was too ready to DI that, but even so, he's at 170. Aura Sphere is just going to kill.
Vivi still sitting at a very comfortable 54%. He's already at 64, and he's trying to get something started with the dash attacks.
Chasing him with him.
And I've noticed a little something from Haze, actually.
Yeah.
Whenever he's committing to an option, like when he wants something, you'll see him do it four or five times.
Yeah, he'll keep going for
it. Yep, I saw him do landing forward air four times. I saw him do landing back air three times. And I'm seeing him going with these dash attacks.
I wonder if...
Maybe it's more like, I really, really want this, and he's like trying to force this to happen a little too much.
You notice when he's grabbing him, he's kind of tossing him on stage for the forward throw mix-up.
Yep.
But, yeah. I wonder if stage control should be
the
option. Yeah. But, I mean, admittedly, Lucario kind of hard to keep from snapping the ledge, at the ledge. Because of his up B, he could just, like, zoom to wherever. Like, look at this. Oh, we read it!
That was
so
great.
Get
that
stage
was good.
Control if you can make reads like that.
But right now, he's like doing a great job playing patiently with those lasers. And he has to be careful with those spot dodges. I've seen him throw it out so many times, and I feel like Vivi's going to start catching on to it soon right there. Yep.
I feel like he's at the up air percent. No, he wasn't. Okay.
Ooh.
Oh, that was so quick. How do you know?
That was the mix. That's something you have to be careful with. Whenever you play projectiles against a character like Lucario or Greninja, you always have to be aware of the fact that they can counter the 2-3 across the stage with the back end.
Vivi is moving right now.
Vivi's momentum right now is insane. This is going to be very, very tough for his comeback from it, but the pivot grab catching the landing.
Yeah, he's definitely one of those players you have to stop before they get going. Otherwise, stuff like this will happen.
Vivi's getting
air dodge.
Every lead right now. He is... Yes, he has him downloaded.
Oh. So you didn't think he got the second hit in air on his way down, and he rolled, but it was still safe.
That movement was jerky. I had to do a double take on that for a second.
He's walking now. That's peak confidence. When you start walking on your opponent.
And walking is definitely one of the most underrated options in Ultimate, because people keep dashing and jumping into shield.
That's what's so good about it. Another F-smash consistently.
Yep.
Finding these F smashes. But and you notice consistently he would get it on Haze's aggression.
Yeah.
Right? Like Haze will fall on him with a nair, with a fair, maybe a dash attack, and every time Vivi would just
And then the other times he would opt for